Hello, my name is Bruce Doran. I'm one of the scientists that works here at Science North. And this video is to help you help students create a great science fair project. Really, the whole point of a science fair is to help students develop the skills and the tools in order to conduct experiments, make observations, do their own research, also problem-solving skills, and also communicate their findings to their peers and also to you. Science fair is an opportunity for anybody, any student of any age, to participate, but it's a great opportunity for grades 7 and up to really learn these skills that they have learned in school and then share them with others. When students are doing a research project or a science fair project, we want these projects to be innovative, original, not something that's been done in the past. We want projects to be repeatable, so we have measurable, repeatable units that we can then look at. Something that will add to science. But honestly, with some of your students, they may not have ideas on what to do. So maybe doing a project that's already been done in the past, but just kind of going beyond the scope of the original project or adding to something, a new spin to that project, that's also acceptable. My recommendation to you, the teachers, is to work with the students on something they're passionate about. You get a lot of times students come up to you and they say, I don't know what to do. I had one student who was really passionate about basketball. So what we did is really start looking at a project where the student looked at the bounceability of different types of balls. So it doesn't have to be a glamorous project or something that's really difficult to do. Something they're passionate about, you'd be surprised how far students will go with that. Now, with any project, they need to follow the scientific method. There needs to be a hypothesis, needs to be repeated measurements, the experiment needs to be repeatable, and they'd be able to also test their hypothesis and whether or not their hypothesis came out true or not. Now, there's nothing wrong if the student's hypothesis was actually false. We learn a lot from science when something doesn't work out and goes against hypothesis. So don't worry if they come up with a result that's different than what you and the students expected. Now, we need to be aware, and students need to be aware of the rules and code of ethics when it comes to science fair projects. So there are rules dealing with very dangerous chemicals and also rules dealing with animals and humans. Now, it doesn't mean that these students are not allowed to use animals or some of their, you know, classmates, but there are specific rules that need to be followed. So my recommendation, whenever you're dealing with animals, with backbones, or humans, as subjects, as part of a science fair project, ask the Youth Science Canada to really see what the rules and regulation comes to that. Also, there may be some projects that you might require a professional. So if a student comes up to you and wants to do a project on bacteria or something with volatile chemicals, obviously, it's not something they can just do, you know, in their kitchen or even in school. So you might have to reach out to different professionals that might have those tools in order to do specific projects. Now, students might be very eager to go on past just your little, you know, science fair competition in your school. They might want to go regionals or Canada-wide science fair project. So in order to do that, they need to really stand out from the crowd. They really need to stand out from the other groups that are there. And they need to have really good presentation skills. They need to be energetic. Their results and everything they're displaying needs to be clean, well-typed. The data needs to be clear, concise, and they need to be able to interpret their data. So it's not just the science, but also how they present their science will give them a leg up on those larger science fairs. When you're representing results, or when they're representing results, there are many different ways of doing that. Obviously, we need to know, you know, different representations like changes over time. They need to understand dependent and independent variables. But a lot of times we see these graphs are just bar graphs. There are many different types of graphs. There are pie charts and other types of graphs that are there. So examine that. Examine what kind of methods or different methods they can represent their data, because again, it will look a lot different than many of the other projects that are presented right now. And now keep in mind that the science fair project does not have to be perfect. These students are learning how to do a science fair project. They're learning how to gather data and to communicate. And it's really what's important about the whole aspect of science fair projects is really applying what they learn. So enjoy and have fun doing science fair projects with your students.